Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to configure a cascading dropdown list using the Syncfusion Angular Dropdown List. Looking at this example, you can see a series of dropdown list components. When I select a particular country name from the country's dropdown list, the corresponding state's dropdown list is enabled. Similarly, when I choose a state from the state's dropdown list, the city dropdown list is enabled. So now, I will show you the steps to render such a series of dropdown list components, and how to configure the values of a dropdown list that depend on another dropdown list's values using an Angular Getting Started application. First, let me open my Getting Started application, where I have added an Angular dropdown list with basic properties. Here, I have bound country names to the data source and mapped the appropriate data source field to the fields property of the dropdown list. Also, I have set the placeholder property value as select a country. If you would like to watch the video on the basics of adding an Angular dropdown list to an app, follow the link provided in the card or in the description below. Now, I will run this example using the command ng-serve. So here, you can see the dropdown list showing country names. To create a cascading dropdown list, first, I need to render the series of dropdown list components. So, I will define one more dropdown list inside the division section. I want to display state names in it, so I will define the object array variable, state data, and assign an array of objects that holds two fields, state name and state ID. For this data source, the appropriate data source field should be mapped to the fields property of the dropdown list component. So here, I need to define the object variable, state fields. Map this state name to the text field, and state ID to the value field. I assign the state data to the data source property, and this state field's variable to the fields property. This data source contains a list of state names, so let me define the placeholder property, and set the value select a state, which will be displayed in the dropdown list component as a description. And now, you can see the dropdown list components rendered one after the other. You can also see that the state dropdown list component is enabled and displaying the state names, even though the country dropdown list has no selected value. So, to disable this state dropdown list and to populate the state names only based on the selected country value, I need to write logic for handling this scenario. To do that, first, I need to define the enabled property and set its value to false within the state dropdown list code. I am going to load the state value in the state dropdown list component based on the selected value in the country dropdown list. For that, I need to map the state names to their countries in the first dropdown list component. So, within the state data object array, I add one more field, country ID with the appropriate values. As I said before, I will be loading the state names based on the selected country value. So, let me define the change event with the relevant handler inside the country dropdown list code. Next, I add template reference variable for both the dropdown list components and access these components using view child directive within this app component TS file. Then, I define not null variables named country object and state object of type dropdown list component to get the dropdown list components instances. Also, I imported the view child directive and dropdown list component class from at angular/core and at syncfusion/ej2 angular dropdowns to access the child component instances. When a country name is selected, this change event will be triggered. So, within this onCountryChange method, I set the value true to this state object enabled property. I form a query and assign it to the variable child data query. I assign this child data query to the state object query property of the state dropdown list component. Then, I import query from the EJ2 data repository to access the query class. Looking at the dropdown list components, the state's dropdown list is initially disabled. And if I select any country name from the country dropdown list, the state dropdown list becomes enabled, showing the relevant state names. Like this, you can render n number of dropdown list components and configure each of its values to be dependent on another. In this video, we have seen how to add a series of drop-down list components to an Angular application. We have also seen how to configure cascading drop-down lists. If you would like to see a working example of the lists in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.